Hey guys, I'm Abhinav. I'm at Speed Monks in Gurgaon and this is my Royal Enfield Interceptor 650. Now, if you see, this is not a stock bike clearly. Well, the suspension, we have upside down forks on this bike right now. The fuel tank has been stripped of all paint and this is Atul. He is the head of all operations, all mechanical operations here at Speed Monks. And Atul will tell us what exactly he's doing. Why is he sanding down the tank? Atul.
See, apparently the only reason we are sanding it because we are giving it a retro kind of a look. So it will be no paint scheme on it. And we will be putting a grain lining onto it. Currently this is what we are doing. We have sanded it off. Now we are doing a bit of a graining styling on it. And we will be putting a clear coat on it. So it gives you the old school retro look. No paint, no nothing on it.
That's not just all. Right now you'll see a lot of rust on the bike. That's because we stripped the paint off about 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago. And the tank has been lying naked, bare naked since then.
We can also do a vintage look on it. With a slight of a rusty look.
Yeah, so that's what we'll do. So we'll get all of this rust off. We'll just leave some on it. And then we will put a clear lacquer on it so that it doesn't rust anymore. So that is what we are going for over here. But that's just not the only change that we are making. We have completely transplanted the front end. These are KTM Duke 390 shocks. Now, in order to fit that, we had to do a lot of hard work. We had to do a lot of R&D because if you could see here, right now we're running the KTM 4-piston, the bi-brake caliper that comes on the KTM 390. These spacers, they're just here for a trial fit right now. We will be fabricating proper spacers now that we know how well, what kind of space we need. So it's just, you know, giving it final touches. The ABS works on this bike, FYI. So if you could see here, there's a little disc behind the rotor and the hub. We had to create it so that the rotor fits into the brake caliper, which again is in a fixed position. We can't move it considering, you know, it's radially mounted and there's just no way to move it left or right.
We have done that was to create a space for the caliper so that it doesn't touch the spokes.
Exactly. If you see here, if we can bring the camera up close, there is not a lot of space between the spokes and the caliper. So, in order to make that fit, because this is a 4-piston caliper, this is not a 2-piston that comes on the stock motorcycle. So, with the pistons being on the inside as well, we had to move the disc away from the hub. We also had to create spacers so that the wheel sits in the middle. Right now we've put in a heavier fork oil. We also had to go in with the KTM upper T and lower T, which will hold the forks. We had to go in for different headline brackets, and then we had to modify the instrument pod, the plate under it, so that it fits here. We also had to do a lot of work on the ignition key so that the stock key, it fits on the upper T of the KTM motorcycle. We're running the stock RE key and this is the RE ignition set. Then if you can also see here, this is the handlebar holders. This is from the Dominar because this is a 22mm bar and KTM runs a slightly fatter bar. So I wanted to run the custom aluminium bar that I got from AliExpress. So for that we have this from the Dominar. I'm also running separate clutch and brake levers. This is an Adeline master cylinder. It's a copy of the Brembo RCS 19, which is one of the best in the world. This works very well. I use it on my Yamaha R15 as well and I'm very happy with it. These clutch and brake levers, they are of aluminum, so they're very high quality. They're much better than stock. So other than that, well, this is the major work that's going in on the motorcycle right now. This is just a teaser. Again, the bike is not ready yet. The final testing remains. Right now, the problem that we are facing in the build is the front suspension. Even though we've added a heavier fork oil, the front suspension is still not being able to take the weight of the motorcycle very well. Now we'll have to look for progressive springs. So, Atul, how much time for that? How much time do you think that'll take to look for springs?
Actually, we have to get into the market and see if we can get some springs or I'll check online. There's some company making heavier springs for that.
Right, for the KTM. So
yeah, exactly.
we'll figure that out and then, you know.
That is the only issue currently left.
Yeah, because right now when we brake the motorcycle slightly tips to the pulls to the right?
Yeah, it could be a reason because it's an older suspension.
Right, yeah.
Might have gone down. So that would be the reason. But anyhow it dies down too much. So to hold that back we have to get a heavier spring.
Hopefully we will be able to wrap up this project in another month. Maximum a month. It's taken a lot of time. It's close to 3 months that the bike has been standing, but it's okay because I'm not gonna ride in the summer anyway. So monsoons are arriving anytime soon. Hopefully my motorcycle will be fully functional and ready to ride in 30 more days. So there's one more thing. We are also planning to put 17-inch rims up front and at the rear so that we can run a 120 section tire at the front and 160 at the rear. My rims are getting made in Bombay. They should be arriving in another week, 10 days. So I will update you in the next vlog on that one. This was a very quick update on what we are doing to the motorcycle because I haven't posted anything on YouTube in a long while. So here we are. So at Speed Monks with Atul, this is Abhinav. I hope you enjoyed this vlog. Thank you.